This old world starts getting me down, and people are just too much for me to face. I'll climb way up to the top of the stairs, and all my cares just drift right into space. On the roof, it's peaceful as can be, and there the world below can't bother me. So when I come home feeling tired and beat, I'll go up where the air is fresh and sweet. Get far away from the hustle and crowds and all that rat race noise down in the street. wish to make it so. Up on the stars put on a show for free, and darling, you can share it all with me. I keep telling you, right smack dab in the middle of town, I found a paradise that's trouble-proof.
Together, please stand in body or in spirit. We'll sing "Welcome to the Mystery."
Think of yourselves as being up on the roof spiritually in this place, in this time where we are together. Behold how good and lovely it is when siblings dwell together. And here we are dwelling together in this city, this big-hearted, tender-hearted, hard-hearted, broken-hearted, lonely-hearted, lovely-hearted city. How good and how lovely, how complex and mystifying, how challenging and rewarding, how important and necessary it is that we dwell together. So whoever you are, however you got here, wherever you're going after this, however you got to this doorway, and wherever you're going when you walk through it at the end, it's good and it's lovely that you are here. Whomever you love, however you express yourself, your best and truest self, whatever your history with the church is or isn't or might be or might have been, it's good and it's lovely that you are here. Welcome to Old South Church. Welcome to the mystery. Welcome to the family.
Welcome to the mystery. Welcome to the great I am. Welcome to the family of the living and the angel band. Welcome to all us sinners and saints. Welcome to believers and to those who ain't.
Ourselves in together with some words we speak back and forth. Spirit of God, gather us into your presence. Spirit of joy, free us to dance with delight. Spirit of gentleness, quiet us with your tender grace. Spirit of liberation, awaken us to your call. Spirit of God, fall afresh on us. Amen.
We are going to sing Dancing in the Street. Are you ready for this? I am so ready for this.
Around the world, are you ready for a brand new beat? Summer's here and the time is right for dancing in the street, dancing in Chicago, down in New Orleans, in New York City. All we need is music, sweet music. There'll be music everywhere. There'll be swinging and swaying and records playing, dancing in the street. Oh, it doesn't matter what you wear, just as long as you are there. So everyone, come on and twirl. Across the nation, a chance for folks to meet. They'll be laughing, singing, and music swinging, but dancing in the street. Philadelphia, PA, Baltimore, and DC now. Can't forget the Motor City. All we need is music, sweet music. There'll be music everywhere. There'll be swinging and swaying and records playing and dancing in the street. Oh, it doesn't matter what you wear, just as long as you are there. So
dancing in the street.
Amen. That's a first for me in church. Love it. Well, beloved ones, would you pray with me? Oh God, may the words of my mouth and the meditations of all of our hearts be acceptable to you. Oh God, our rock and our redeemer. Amen. The city has a beat all its own. Each neighborhood with its own rhythm and groove, each block swaying to a song made up by a neighbor's bachata or hip hop or salsa or old school rock and roll, or God bless us if Kids Bop is on. The city has a beat all its own. Scene. Yesterday, I was walking to get my Dunkies iced, and this. A woman and a man holding hands at the intersection, they look across the road, break hands, and start waving wildly. In a car, a couple waves wildly back at them, everyone's face so full of glee just at seeing each other, at the bliss that in this big city, you never know when a beloved one will appear just across the intersection. Scene. Through an initiative of the mayor's office, over the course of the summer, various neighborhood thoroughfares will be shut down to car traffic and opened up to street vendors and artists and games for children and general merriment. This past Sunday, Center Street in JP was highlighted. Neighbors filled the streets, sharing in treats, and Teddy, age 4, and a dear friend of mine, Teddy took the street by storm. In his low-riding tricycle, he weaves in and out of the two-legged and four-legged traffic, deftly maneuvering the street as only a toddler could. Because he knows that this is his home. He knows it's his home. Scene. Out on Copley Square, a busker lays down the beat to Black Streets, No Diggity, and people gather around. You smile because you know. The smell of arepas fills the air. And stop for a moment and listen. Below the beat, that you know it. Listen for the people. At least 3, if not 4 or 5 languages spoken all at once, and the street moving to its own beat. Scene, the Orange Line. A toddler in her stroller is eating a snack. Dozens of neighbors are all on their way somewhere, and one neighbor, stooped far over and lilting to and fro as only someone high on opiates could be. Her forehead is inches from the ground, and her hand clings to the pole. The man standing next to her cautiously puts his hand out, ready to catch her in case she would fall. Strangers caring for strangers, but with problems bigger than any one of us could fix on our own. Scene. The emergency department of Boston Medical Center, a family, 2 children, a mom and a dad, 3 suitcases. Evening comes. They're not sick. They've just recently arrived in Boston by way of plane, by way of boat, by way of sheer grit, by way of Port-au-Prince. There's nowhere in this big, great city for these children of God to lay their heads, and so they linger there in the emergency room. The staff does their best to be kind, but they know they can't let them stay. The government works at fits and starts at a problem with deep roots, and yet very human faces. Those are all just scenes from my own vantage point. I wonder what you've seen, what bits of beauty and terror, love and loss this great city has shown you. close your eyes and see it. Those glimmers that the city has offered. This city on a hill, that great pilgrim dream. We haven't quite made it yet, have we? This city, this place we call home, where the dropped R and brusque giving of directions to tourists is a love language all its own. This city of needles and guns, buses and bikes, smiles and screams, potholes that will break your car axle, and 1,000 stories that'll break your heart. Don't you ever wonder what God dreams of for the city? The prophet Isaiah did. Not Boston, but the city of Jerusalem. The people had been exiled and then they came back. And the city wasn't whole anymore. The walls had crumbled way back when the city was taken and rampaged by the Babylonians. The temple had fallen, desecrated. And the city was full of people who didn't quite remember what it was to be faithful. A city full of injustice, broken walls and broken hearts. And yet Isaiah dreamed of gates wide open, a highway into the city, which is not to say a smog-clogged six-lane road, but a way made clear so that all could enter freely and remain safely. And God's self speaking over the great city, look, your Savior comes. You are a holy people, a people redeemed. God has sought you out, not forgotten. You are a city not forsaken. Boston, our home, the city that this church finds itself at the very heart of. And so, Old South Church, dream with me. What if we sang over our city the words of the prophet Isaiah? You are the beloved of God. Redeemed, sought out, not forsaken. Each and every neighborhood sought out, each and every neighbor, every single one, sought out, not forgotten. You are a city not forsaken. Church, what if this was our love song to the city? And what if that love song then compelled our feet and our hands and our pens and our votes and our money to move? A city not forsaken. Not just a place for the wise and the wealthy, but for everyone. For each neighbor, a home, a dignified place to rest. For each neighbor, good food. For each neighbor, open doors for education and work. Each neighbor, safe from violence. God's dream, our own song. Can't you see it? I know you can. I know it because I see you. I see you volunteering your precious free time. I see you calling up strangers from church and offering care until those strangers become beloved community. I see you getting to know your neighbors and learning about the stuff that affects them. I see you turning out 45 people to GBIO's Housing Justice Action. I see you speaking your own voice, telling your story. We've all got a part to play in God's great dream for this city. Scene, the splash pad. I know it in my bones that heaven will have splash pads. The laughter of children filling the air, adults with lemonade and pretzels, church, its kids from all cultures sharing in sacred space and speaking the language of play, which is to say God's own language. Water balloons and tag and smiles wider than God could have ever dreamed of. Scene, open streets, local artists hawking their wares, the smell of Jamaican patties co-mingling with the smell of hot dogs, with the unmistakable scent of the fresh mango from the guy who sells the freshest mangoes out of his truck on Columbus Avenue. Kids on bikes, toddlers on trikes, sidewalks evened out so that no wheelchair gets stuck in the cracks. A way made clear for all of us, each neighbor sought out. Open Streets asks, what if this city was for everyone? What if this city was for everyone? This city could be for everyone. May we, with the help and the dream of God, make it so. Amen.
Is making you lonely, you can always go downtown. When you've got worries, all the noise and the hurry seems to help, I know. Downtown, just listen to the music of the traffic in the city. Linger on the sidewalk where the neon signs are pretty. How can you lose? The lights are much brighter. You can forget all your troubles, forget all your cares, and go downtown. Things will be great when you're downtown. Never place for sure, downtown. Everything's waiting for you. Don't hang around and let your problems surround. There are movie shows downtown. Maybe you know some little places to go where they never close. Downtown, just listen to the rhythm of a gentle bossa nova. You'll be dancing with them too before the night is over. Happy again. The lights are much brighter there. You can forget all your troubles. Forget all your cares, or go downtown, where all the lights are bright. Downtown, waiting for you tonight. Downtown, you're gonna be all right now. Understand you, someone who is just like you and needs a gentle hand to guide them along. So maybe I'll see you there. We can forget all our troubles, forget all our cares, and go downtown. Things will be great when you're downtown. Don't wait a minute more, downtown. Everything's waiting for. Thank you.
so, the weather's warm spiritually and meteorologically, and it's time to open the doors of us and let the prayers flow out onto the streets and in the byways and into the neighborhoods and over the roofs and around the region and across the world. So we'll spend a moment just centering ourselves, confident of that gracious and gentle and generous one who brought us here and who urges us to open the doors and windows of our hearts and our lives, that the best of us can flow out in prayer. We'll spend a moment being grounded, then I'll have a few tiny little words to say, and then there'll be a time for any of us who care to speak a word of prayer out into the great city of creation, the great city of the human race, the human family, the great city of all the universe. If you have a prayer that you'd like to put into words, just say it out when that time comes, as loud as you can so I can hear it. I'll repeat it for the sake of our friends who are participating in this service online. And then I'll say, God, in your mercy, and invite you to respond by saying, hear our prayer. God, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And our time of prayer will end in a little more centering silence and then some delicious song. So let us pray. Open us up, O God. Open the doors of us. Open the windows of us. Open the eyes and ears of us. Open the conscience and hope of us. Help us with our prayers to hold in our hearts and minds. Help us to reach with our words and our gestures. Help us to guard with our policies and our programs, especially those who will now have to try harder to find a place in schools and colleges and universities, and those who will have a harder time believing in themselves, believing in the institutions around them, believing even in the promises of our society. And those who are beset by storms and droughts of all kinds, and those whom we know who even today, even now, even this evening, struggle and hope and yearn and long. We hope and yearn and long with them. And we name now, either in the silence of our hearts or in our words, those whom we lift up into the light of your presence. Strength and courage for Mary Kapoor battling brain cancer. God, in your mercy, hear our prayer.
For a family whose loved one is in the hospital with the end result uncertain.
For a family with a loved one in the hospital and the end uncertain. God, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Healing for Josh and strength for his parents, God, in your mercy,
Oh, hear our prayer. For the people of Ukraine, God, in your mercy, hear our prayer. For our new pastor, John, and for this church, as we mobilize to greet him and invite him to join this work, God, in your mercy, hear our prayer. So many of our prayers lie so far beyond the reach of mere words. Hear them all, not according to the poverty of our asking, but according to the richness and abundance of your grace.
friends. It was a Thursday night. A Thursday night in the middle of a great big city of Jerusalem that Jesus gathered his friends in for a meal. A meal that would hold them through all the tumult of their lives and that holds us still. And at that meal, Jesus took the bread. He gave thanks to God for it. He blessed it and he broke it. And he passed it around to them, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body. It has been given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way, he took the cup. He gave thanks for it. He blessed it. And he passed it around to all of them, saying, "Take and drink. This is the cup of the new covenant, poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sin. Whenever you drink of this, remember me." Friends, would you reach out your hands to bless this table with me, knowing that as you bless the table, those blessings go all the way across the room and bless each other. Come, God, come. Dive deep into these cups. Bind yourself into this bread. Bless this meal that it might be for us holy food. Bless us that we might be holy people. Gather up the crumbs of our lives and make us whole. Amen. We'll share communion like this. You'll come down these side aisles. Someone will hand a piece of bread to you and you'll dip it in the cup, taking both together. Then you'll go back through the center aisles, which will bring you by our candle lighting stations, where you can light a candle in a prayer that hasn't quite found words or just to bring a little more light into this world. The bread that I broke has gluten and egg in it. If that's not good for you, Dawn will have a gluten-free station over here by the font. All of these cups only contain non-alcoholic grape juice so that there would be no physical barrier between you and these tastes of God's grace. But maybe there's something else. Maybe there's something that you think you're supposed to believe that you just don't. Maybe there's something you've done. Maybe you're not baptized or a member of this church. Maybe you've been told that you don't belong here. Maybe you think that though God's grace surely covers the whole of the universe, it might just pass you by. Well, then know this. That night at that table with his friends was one who would deny him, one who would betray him to his death, and every last one of them would leave him alone when he needed them the most. And he ate with them, so surely he would eat with you. Come now. All you need to be at this table is to be hungry for the love of God. Come now, for all things are ready.
Thank you. When summer heat has you swooning and you feel like communion, you can always come downtown. The city is here for us, and our offerings are a way for us to be here for the city. The city embraces us, and our gifts are a way for us to practice embracing the city, because God knows sometimes it does take practice. And the city challenges us, doesn't it? And our gifts are a way for us to learn to challenge the city back to be more generous, more spirited, more open, more lovely. So freely we have received. Even so, let us freely give.
City. We'll sing this together. Please stand in body or in spirit.
City. Hallelujah. Oh, what a beautiful.
beautiful city, beautiful ones, may we go out from this place singing the song of God over this great city, and know that when you go with the blessing of the God who created you, with Jesus who liberated you, and with the Holy Spirit, your companion and guide all the way long. Amen.
We heal. Our service is over. Let our service begin.
Indeed, the city is out there. It's a little humid, but beautiful nonetheless. But all around you are beautiful neighbors worth knowing. So before you bring the love out there, share it in here. May the peace of Christ be with you. Now share it with each other.